according to Director of Traffic in Uganda Police Force Central Police, Lawrence Nwabine, over 3,300 border border accidents are registered in Kampala on a monthly basis.
2 decades, what have you done? For us police, we are sitting on it and challenging you. Those who took it away, what have you done in 2 decades? And I want an answer from members of parliament.
While interfacing with the members on the parliamentary forum on road safety, Nwabine attributed the problem to impunity and tasked MPs to enact policies to restore sanity on the road.
Impunity. You, as all of us Ugandans, we have built impunity in our society. We shall harvest from that impunity.
He courted Parliament to allocate more funds to road safety to facilitate police to mitigate road accidents.
Let me ask you, where is the speed regulation? Do you know that when you amended the act, this issue of speed, which is critical, was removed and is in the Roads Act? Do you have enforcement there?
In their discussion, members of parliament also put traffic police on spot to explain why they have slept on job to leave border border riders and motor vehicle drivers to mess up traffic rules as if there are no traffic laws in Uganda.
There is nothing more important than a life. You cannot compare. You know, you want to construct many roads. But in constructing all these many roads, we are actually creating challenges for Ugandans. You know that once roads are constructed, then the road traffic accidents increase. Am I lying? The road accidents increase because we value more of the road construction for the cars. We don't value constructing roads that are safe for vehicles, for pedestrians, for the border borders. Yes.
The Tororo District Woman MP, Sarah Opendi, blamed the escalating road carnage to very narrow roads constructed in the country, which are prone to road accidents because they are not road friendly.
In a country where vehicles have increased, in a country where we rely on road transport as the means of transporting human beings and goods, how can you have 2 lanes? And 2 lanes without a road separator. So everybody overtakes anywhere at blind spots. And at the end of the day, what happens? Road accidents.
At the end of the engagement, MPs resolved to push for increment of road safety budget in order to save lives of Ugandans lost on roads.
Unless we make government to begin prioritizing and taking issues of road safety seriously, then the battle will remain there. That is on budget. Otherwise, I don't think some of these issues I hear people blaming parliament, that it is the parliament that budgets. And unfortunately, it comes from government. You members of parliament, you are asking for money, and yet you sit in the parliament and you are the ones who appropriate. But when it comes to actual appropriation and figures, it comes from them. Parliament does very little to change anything. If anybody thinks this is wrong, I am here to challenge me.
This story was compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news in Parliament.